Now, before we finish, I want to actually now showcase you yet another example of similar coded photography, except this time we're going to talk about the concept of a Flutter shutter camera. The Flutter shutter camera basically now attempts to do the same thing the coded camera did, except that this time around, rather than change the aperture, it wants to change something about the shutter. In coded aperture, we added obstructions to the aperture. In Flutter shutter, let's control when the shutter opens and closes. So, you know, again, have the whole thing and just figure out how to open and close it in a specific manner. Just to kind of look at this, let's look at this series of examples. A standard camera, or a traditional camera, when it takes a picture, when the shutter is open, you get one frame, right? And these are, again, ideas come from this Rosker et al. 2006 paper that is also referenced at the end, and also will provide you the links for you to look at in detail. I do encourage you to look at these papers to kind of get a good sense of the exact technical details. I'm just summarizing them and giving you the big overview of these concepts here. So, of course, when I open the shutter like this, and if the car is moving, what I would basically get is the car is moved, and if I actually have the shutter, you'd actually get some sort of a blur, a motion blur in this instance, right? Let's look at it again. When I open the shutter, car is moving, and of course, depending on how long the shutter is open, I will get a blurry image like this. Well, let's actually do something interesting. Let's actually change how the shutter opens and also control it when it closes. So now basically what we'll do is we'll open and close the shutter, and this is basically showing you this. Now, if I know exactly how this opens and closes, this is interesting. Now, I do get a motion blurred image, but if you notice, this one has very specific sharp lines. Let's look at them next to each other. This was when the shutter was open the whole time, and this is when we kind of flutter shuttered it, that is, opened and closed it at different rates. Here, everything is blurred. In this one, you do see some blur, but actually, there is a little bit of a better signature. So you, for example, see these lines at different, you know, there's no, of course, detail here whatsoever, but here you actually see different characteristic lines on this image. This actually is much more useful than this, and if I actually know this code, then I actually know a lot more about this image too. And that's the basic idea. If I know the code on how and when I open this, I should be able to kind of use this information to model the output that I'm getting after all of this is accumulated or integrated. Here, I know all of it, but since I have no control over how the aspects of what happened in the middle, everything is blurred. So Rosker et al. Actually designed this camera by actually just taking an existing camera and putting some sort of an additional controller that would basically change the control of the, how the shutter opens and closes with a digital process here. So they actually could actually figure out the exact code on how the shutter would open. So they created this new camera to do this, and they did a lot of other experiments with it. Again, I recommend you to look at the paper for more details.